A new warning from researchers at UC Davis about medical marijuana and the people using it as medicine.
Trying to caution those patients, you know, you may have unknowingly used a product that could be lethal.
People with weakened or depleted immune systems are at the greatest risk of infection from medical marijuana.
New tonight, CBS 13's Drew Balea spoke with the lead researcher about what he found to be alarming. Drew?
Well, yeah, and not only that, but this research is really difficult to come by because in the federal government's eyes, marijuana is still illegal. So because of all this, consumers are left with a lot of questions, and now medical professionals have a warning. Buyer beware.
This is Dr. George Thompson. He specializes in patients with fungal infections.
You mean open it up?
He noticed a strange trend in people with depleted immune systems.
Pneumonia, basically. They cough. They can have nosebleeds from sinus infections.
The key thing, tying them together, they were all taking medical marijuana for pain relief.
This is a material that's in nature. It's full of bacteria and fungi. It would make sense that that could be a point source for these patients to have their infection.
Thompson used an off-campus lab to test 20 samples of marijuana from 20 different dispensaries.
All of them had bacteria and fungal organisms present.
The contaminants are nearly harmless to people with strong immune systems, but to people receiving chemotherapy for leukemia, lymphoma, or other disorders like organ transplants or AIDS, the bacteria can be devastating.
We're really trying to caution those patients. You know, you may have unknowingly used a product that could be lethal.
People have an expectation that the stuff that they get at dispensaries is going to be safe and clean and well tested. But the fact of the matter is that this is an unregulated environment up until now.
There are no state warnings or regulations for people using marijuana as medicine. But they're coming by January 1st of next year.
We're responsible for the state licensing and enforcement structure for medical cannabis.
Lori Ajax with the Bureau of Medical Cannabis Regulation is heading up the agency, piecing together the rules.
Making sure we're protecting the patient, the public, the environment.
But for now, dispensaries and cultivators follow their own best practices, which may differ from business to business.
So the bacteria and the fungus that we're talking about are pretty common. You can find them on things like mulch or cut flowers or any really plant that is decaying. And the concern isn't for folks that have a strong immune system. It's those people who have a depleted immune system and their bodies simply can't fight back.
All right, Drew, thanks very much. Live for us tonight in Davis.